Before we officially start this video, if you have not seen the results of the previous round, the link will be in the description below and in the information tab on the top right corner of the video. Man, I've always wanted to do this. Last time on Total Drama Bracket, 12 contestants went head-to-head to solidify the first round. There were some blowouts and some close calls, but in the end, Justin, Cody, Trent, Harold, Courtney, and Heather made it to the Sweet 16. Now we head into this video with 8 new matchups in hand. Who got the stakes to make it to the Elite 8? Whose heart is going to break? Will I ever be able to clean out my laptop so we can have more space? All the answers, except the last one probably, will be answered here on Total Drama Bracket. So after essentially a 1 month hiatus from it, we're going to hop into the Sweet 16. We have 8 matches that'll stir some interesting discussion of who is better than who. The matchups will be Lashana vs. Katie, Sadie vs. Heather, Tyler vs. Justin, Ezekiel vs. Owen, DJ vs. Trent, Noah vs. Harold, Izzy vs. Courtney, and Duncan vs. Cody. As a reminder, we'll be looking at the personality and overall development throughout the first 3 seasons of the Total Drama series. Without further ado, let's dive on into the first bout, Lashana vs. Katie. If you're looking for that big old stereotypical sassy black woman, Lashana is in the house. She was featured in all 3 seasons and her attitude was noticed for each one. In the island, she was a strong personality that was able to make it to the final 5. Her biggest development is with her top arch rival, Heather. The two went head to head early on and often. Every time Heather tries to be the alpha female for her team, Lashana is the first to stand up to her demands. She also had some mini moments with Harold that developed into something more surprisingly, and was a close friend of Gwen in season 1. How she got eliminated in the island was completely idiotic, with a surprise twist of the eliminated contestants getting the opportunity to eliminate someone from the final 5. Starting off with Idiot 1 and Idiot 2, one of them who we'll talk about later on, decided to vote for Lashana because they like her. This resulted in more than half of the ex-campers and a parent accidentally voting her off instead. Heading into the action, we got to see Lashana in more complications than in her time in the island. Her biggest arc is her battle to regain the trust she lost with their teammates. During a reward challenge where everyone played doctor, she and Duncan were able to find out the reasonings for the cast's sudden diseased plague. When Chris announced that an award of getting away from the set for a weekend will be given to just one member, she brought out the fake tears to receive it for herself. When her team found out that she deceived them about her true feelings, they did not take it well. There were various times where her team left her dry, including Harold. She did everything she could to gain her team's support once again, and she was able to do it successfully before the merger. She was even able to somewhat befriend Heather. However, she was eliminated shortly after due to Harold not trusting her fully, something that I explained in a previous video. She did forgive him before she hopped into the limousine. As we dig into her time in the world tour, she was eliminated early on being one of the many victims of Alejandro's schemes. Though she had a huge moment beating the crap out of Heather. Even then, there's still a lot going for her character-wise and is someone to look out for in this tournament. Sadly, you can't say the same for Katie. She was only featured in the island and was eliminated very early on. She's the best friend of Sadie and they did everything together. During the Sucky Outdoors episode, it was put to the test when they got separated from the rest of the team. The two got into a heated argument but were able to make it up when they returned to camp. However, they were the last to return, which costed their team the win, which meant one of them was going to get the boot. And it was Katie. Even if you don't compare her to Lashana, she had little to no interest and was simply an extra body to fill this cast. So it's not even a contest that Lashana is the first to make it to the Elite 8. Next, we have Sadie vs. Heather. For Sadie, we might as well put a copy and paste from when I talked about Katie because they are so alike to the point where it's creepy. After Katie was eliminated, it was clear that Sadie was just an extra body in the background and was used as an example to not get on Courtney's bad side. That's all you can talk about, really. As we hop to Heather, she was able to get past Jelf to make it to the Sweet 16, and compared to her opponent, she has a lot more to discuss with. she's made various of enemies and friendships alike. Heather was the number one villain for the island, and she was able to grow more as each season progressed. Her bouts with Alejandro are very well noted in the world tour, and did help us see the good even more so than in action. So we can go ahead and say that this is a no contest once again, as Heather gets a spot in the Elite Eight. The next matchup will be Tyler versus Justin. Tyler was only featured in the island and the world tour. During his time in the island, he was okay. He's known as the clumsy jock that always enjoys showing off his athleticism, only to fail miserably at every attempt. He did develop a strong relationship with Lindsay, but it did come with a painful price by our top villain in the island. He was plucked from the competition because of his phobia for chickens. There was no time dedicated to action for him, so his development continued through the world tour. For about half of his time spent there, it was focused on trying to get Lindsay to remember him, and it got pretty old pretty fast. But as soon as Lindsay was eliminated, he had a chance to blossom more. Too bad it was kind of wasted because he turned into Alejandro's lackey and a tool in the World Tour's Love Triangle fiasco. He was eliminated for costing his team the challenge in the X-Files episode. While there was a funny moment or two for him, he did not play a huge role in either season he participated in. Also, there were many times where his torture stopped being funny and just became plain cruel. When it comes to Justin, on the other hand, a man who's made it past Beth in the preliminary, he was able to grow during his time in the game. That was especially the case in action. While having just as much screen time as his opponent in the island, I would say that he was able to have more interesting moments in the second season he was a part of. Plus, he was able to play around his shortcomings when he was losing his pretty boy advantage in the action. Justin will defeat his second opponent in the tournament to advance to the second round. Our next bout will be Ezekiel versus Owen. Man, this is another dud. So here's another set of characters that I have little to no interest in, but we'll make it work. Ezekiel? Oh my god, Ezekiel. Alright, so he was only featured in the island and the world tour. His moments in the island were simply being the socially awkward homeschooler who ended up saying sexist comments, and that made him become the first man booted in the island. During his time away from the game, he kind of became...
Yo, yo, dog, check it out! Being famous has totally changed my life!
What am I supposed to take from this? Like, for real? So when the World Tour came in, his cockiness shot up higher, boasting that he was going from worst to first. However, due to Zeke being Zeke, he found ways to screw his team over and became the first eliminated. Again. But wait, there's more! Because he found a way back on the plane and became a refugee. No matter how many times the crew tries to get rid of him, he comes back more of a disgusting mess than ever. They really made him unappealing as hell. They turned this small town homeschool kid to a probable disease carrying monster. I mean, what did this guy even do to deserve this treatment? Is he that much of an unlikable character? Anyways, let's get into Owen, who, to be honest, is not that interesting of a character. He was featured in all three seasons, probably because you can get the most jokes out of this plump marshmallow. Every episode he's heavily involved in had something to do with food, farting, or some sort of combination of the two. He did build a relationship with Izzy, which you can probably guess is as crazy as you think. Somehow he gobbled his way into the final two with Gwen and won it all. However, his winnings became obsolete after he decided to sacrifice it for a bigger prize, which led into another season in total drama action. During his time there, it was more... wait... diet jokes? Constipated jokes? Okay, alright then. He broke his jaw during his first stint and was eliminated due to the Mary Sue powers of Courtney. What a doll. However, he did return in the game, but not the way you think. He was hired by Total Drama to have the role of a mole and sabotage many of the challenges during his time there. But he was caught by... you guessed it, Courtney, because of her lawyers. Again, can we not have her be involved in every big reveal? So, when he was ratted out, he was tossed from the show along with Courtney, who was being eliminated the old-fashioned way. When we get into the world tour, his importance dropped down a little as he became more of an annoyance for Al. See, Al hated being called Al because of his family issues, so when Owen kept calling him Al, he was livid as hell. We also see a growth of Owen's relationship with Noah too, and his relationship with Izzy ended after she became very smart, which gave him a shot at Blaney, who was, yeah. Unfortunately, he was eliminated in the Niagara Brawls episode. Of course, there was a lot more of Owen to discuss with than Ezekiel, and between the two, I think Owen is easier to handle than Zeke. They've shown many times that Zeke was nothing more than a cockroach that was easily crushed in the reality TV business. While he's nothing but a fat man joke, he did have genuine relationships and decent development in his arc. I have to give it to Owen. Next up is DJ versus Trent. DJ here is the definition of a mama's boy. He was featured in all three seasons and is one of the nicest characters to enter in the game. Throughout his tenure in the island, he was shown to have a soft spot for the animals, most notably a rabbit he found and named Bunny in the sucky outdoors. He also has a tendency to get scared pretty easily, and that flaw did cost him the game in the episode Hook, Line, or Screamer for not even getting spooked by Chef. While he did have a good amount of time in the island, that didn't push much of a narrative to him. In action, he had an intriguing arc with Chef. Chef dragged DJ into an illegal alliance to help DJ become more of a man, when really, it's just so we can get a share of the million. It messed with DJ's morality and it made him become guiltier. It affected him so much that even Mama Conscious hit him upside the head, which gave him the willingness to come clean to the alliance he had and made the decision to eliminate himself and dipped. It was well played by Total Drama to put him in this position. Setting up to someone that's forcing you to do something you're not comfortable with is something anyone can relate to. Standing up to someone that is forcing you to do something you're not comfortable with is something anyone can aspire to. However, in World Tour, they put him into a ridiculous scenario. He accidentally broke a mummified dog that cursed him, which put him in various scenarios of getting into many scuffles with a variety of animals. It got so bad to the point where he was desperately trying to find ways to leave the game instead of just straight up quitting like Duncan did in episode 1, or when he did it in action. However, it was proven that it was all in his head thanks to a certain Alejandro, which, surprise to no one, ended up being one of the many manipulated and axed because of this villainous man. I was not a huge fan of the arc he was thrown into because it felt incredibly cheap, and it took away any sympathy for a character that wants to find a way to lose so bad and not do the obvious. Say I quit and call it a day. But it's better than this mess of a character! Woohoo! Trent. A guy that made it past an anger management issued character to get to this point. Is someone that has no real character development outside of being a guy with a guitar who loves to play the dumb card in season 1. Then I questioned whether he did that hard stuff in action from his obsession of winning Gwen's heart even though he's already won it, until he lost it. Then he simply was diminished to a guitar playing douchebag in a boy band. So you know what? Screw you! DJ is moving on and Trent will be tossed in the garbage like he needs to be. Now we're going into the tough ones for me, starting off with Noah versus Harold. Noah is known to be the most sarcastic jerk in the entire island, which is something a lot of people enjoyed about him. Too bad he didn't show his charm a lot in the island because he was eliminated due to not being a participant in the dodgeball challenge for Dodge Brawl. But hey, at least he kissed a dude's ear while he's sleeping, that'll definitely get those clicks. Ayy. As we skip action due to not being one of the Lucky 14 to get a shot at the million, his time in the World Tour was pretty alright. While he didn't have the most memorable moments during his tenure, his dry sense of humor was a bit of a refresher that was much needed. He was perfect to be a part of a duo with Owen. While Owen's attributes were out there heavily in the island and action, Noah helped simmer him down and was the eye-opener in Alejandro's true nature. Which, surprise to no one, ended up being one of Alejandro's victims for putting him in the negative light. When compared to Harold, who defeated Lindsay to get his spot, I can't say there's a lot to Noah that you could give much of an edge to. With Harold having more screen time than his previous competitor, he had more developing arcs with Duncan, Lashana, and Heather to name a few. Both are relatable in their own way, they have their own type of social awkwardness in the end where Noah can be too much of a smartass and Harold being able to outgeek just about anyone. However, I'm gonna have to go Harold with having much more opportunities to shine and was executed well. Plus, he's a much more fun character to see interact with the rest of the crew. We're starting to wind down as we head into our second to the last matchup with Izzy versus Courtney, Battle of the Crazies. For Izzy, she was an insane and resilient woman that is completely unpredictable. She was featured in all three seasons and made her presence known throughout each one. Izzy's time in the island certainly was something. During her time, she was eliminated, kind of, because of the RCMP having a bounty on her head. Later in the season, she was able to return to the game and continue her crazy adventures. She started a rivalry with Chef that had some fun moments and built a relationship with our big bud Owen. She was eliminated in the final 7 due to Heather wanting that vengeance for being tranquilized by her. As we dip into action, her amount of crazy dove into having many personalities in her pocket. The first was Kaleidoscope, or E-Scope for short. She emphasizes that it was her official name. It didn't take long for E-Scope to be eliminated for not being able to outperform Duncan in an acting challenge. However, Izzy was not going anywhere because of the technicality of E-Scope getting kicked. Shortly after, she had another persona named Explosivo. Explosivo was obsessed with exploding things to the point where it costed her team yet another challenge, and Izzy was eliminated. As we traveled into the world tour, her crazy moments continued to thrive on. From talking to a camel to playing in radioactive juices, her status as a wild card was still in play throughout her tenure. However, when she was concussed, she was able to figure out time travel and became one of the smartest people in the world. Somehow the army was aware of this and took her into custody to figure out what she knows on the subject. Before she dipped with them, she cut ties with Owen. That's some story arc. While for Courtney, she was able to get past Gwen in the preliminary round. I would say compared to Izzy's arc, Courtney was more controlled and a bit easier to follow than her counterpart. While her arc with Duncan is probably the most annoying to me when it comes to the total drama couples, I do feel it was stronger than Izzy's with Owen. However, for Izzy, she was a more fun character to watch. Her relationship with Chef might be one of the most notable and interesting to see them interact. And as much as Courtney is a strong competitor and someone you just love to hate, Izzy is a character you love to, well, love. This one is a tough decision for sure and could go either way. But in the end, I'm going to have to give Courtney the slight edge mainly because of being a part of bigger storylines more than Izzy. The final battle will be Duncan versus Cody. This one will be interesting because the two are heavily involved in a bit of a rivalry in the world tour, but we will get into that shortly. Starting off with introducing Duncan, a juvenile delinquent who played major roles in all three seasons of the Total Drama franchise. In the island, his biggest arcs involved with Courtney and Harold in the beginning of the season, with being Harold's bully and Courtney's love interest during their time. The two arcs were intertwined for a bit after Courtney and Duncan became an official couple, and Harold was not happy about it when he found out. He tampered with the votes to get his girl canned. As the game went on, he became well known as one of the main big brains on the island. With starting a guys-only alliance for a brief period, and teaming up with Heather a little as well. We also got to see a bit of a soft spot as well by getting DJ a new rabbit and admitting it to Lashana why he did that. He was eliminated in the final 4 because of Owen's stomach. In action, his arc with Harold blossomed as the two constantly bickered at each other for a large period. As the season went on, the two did find some amount of respect for each other, before Owen screwed it up. Oh, and his relationship with Courtney became pretty complicated because of that whole clip played on the Aftermath episode and had returned into the game with certain perks. Duncan grew more and more sick of Courtney's antics to get far into the game and played a huge part in voting her off, and it costed their relationship as a whole. Until he won, depending on where you live. When we got to the world tour, his arc went on a spiral. Because of a stipulation of being forced to sing every episode, he decided to quit on the first episode of the season. This put everyone in shock, especially Courtney and Gwen. but the game went back to him after the two girls found him in a British garage band. And on his return...
Ow! Hey.
Just why? So, for most of his time in his second stint, he tried his hardest to get Courtney the boot because she turned into a nutjob after figuring out about his kiss with Gwen. When he was finally able to get that monkey off his back, he was eliminated shortly after in the final five. Yeah, the World Tour was pretty much downhill for Duncan in my opinion because of that unnecessary love triangle that he freaking skyrocketed. It felt forced as hell, and it took me out of the World Tour. Thankfully, Cody made it a little more bearing. Before we get into his time taking the skies, Cody was able to come out of the preliminary against Bridget. Compared to Duncan, he doesn't have nearly as much screen time with only being in two seasons and not really having any in the island. I could say that for Cody's time in the World Tour is a lot better compared to Duncan because while it was driven by only one narrative with Sierra, the seeds for it was planted better, and I got a lot more sympathy for him and his shortcomings. Plus, he had some solid moments against Duncan for taking the girl he truly loved. Still, this tournament isn't just about the World Tour, and sadly, Cody was not featured a lot outside of that. For Duncan, on the other hand, while getting into a subpar season, he played a bigger role in the series than most characters in the game. So for this one, Duncan will wrap up the Elite Eight. Do you agree with the winners of the Sweet 16? If not, who do you think should have won and why? Which matchup are you excited to see in the Elite Eight? You can chat about it in the comments section below. If you want to be the first to see the next round, click the subscribe and the bell icons to get the latest from me. Until then, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.